you know, rivers can't read, they flow, so we're in Florida. I actually live in Miami County, Georgia. It's true, I live in Georgia. I will hasten to add, you'll see why later, that I do not now, nor have I ever lived in Valdosta, but first, good news. As some of you are aware, we are working on trying to get a Streetville River cap built at the confluence of the Little Hokucci River just west of Valdosta. It's looking good so far. The city of Valdosta voted to send a letter of support this evening. The Files County Commission has decided to bring us a letter. And I heard a rumor that the Suwannee River Water Management District has sent a letter. If that's true, I take my hat off to you. So that's coming along. Of course, we're copying these ones on the Suwannee River, where the cap's exempt at Allen Park. Now, why I said that thing to start with is, in case you haven't heard, there was a spill last night from Valdosta. And at 9:08 this morning, we finally got a press release, and how did we know about it, from Nestle County Department of Health. Exactly why we should have to hear from them instead of directly from Valdosta. So the press release gets around to, after several paragraphs, to say, how many gallons of raw sewage were discharged from a manhole in Sugar Street, which of course probably means the location of the Suwannee? 7,592,910 gallons. This is a major spill. They say they have fixed it. They blame it on a contractor, as seems to be normal for Valdosta utilities. And the way they found out there was a problem was, the spill was not at Watershed Wastewater Treatment Plant, but the staff at Watershed Wastewater Treatment Plant, here in this press release, notified Environment Services that flow into the plant had decreased by 50% over the previous few days. And this thing must have been going on for several days, because the contractor disconnected the reference cable at the Remington lift station, and once they found out what was wrong, they reconnected and the problem stopped. But 7,592,910 gallons. And how this is related to Nestle is at Madison Blue Springs, where they own far more land than Madison Blue Springs, they are. You know, if I were Nestle, I wouldn't want to pump the water out of there when this happens. So that might be why they want another alternative location, like, for example, Jenny Springs. Thank you, Merrily, for noting that. Everyone should listen to Merrily. So, I have sent you a letter, which I believe you have copies there. I sent last night about it with the permitting system. I won't go into great detail, it's all the letter. Please deny Seven Springs permit renewal. I know you have a number of issues. For example, there's only six of you when you're all here, there should be nine. That's particularly unfortunate because two of the missing ones are for where many of the people live, up the swamp, including with the Gooch and Palapa, and the Santa Fe and Quaxaw. So it'd be really nice if the governor would get around to appointing the rest of your board members. But y'all like that too. Yeah, maybe they'd even like to appoint somebody who's an environmentalist for a little, you know, diversity on the board. Like somebody who might be in this room, for example. And as you've probably heard, there's some potential new legislation, some of which is came from a state senator, actually from South of the state, proposing 12.5 cents per gallon charged to Nestle for every gallon in the pump to make them on par with Coke and Pepsi. I think that's a grand idea. But you don't actually need more board members or more laws. You have the statutory authority, as I think Jim David mentioned. You have the statutory authority to review and even revoke any permit, even if you just renewed it last year, for example, the one at Madison Blue Springs. And I recommend that you do review it. And I really wish that you would do something about this problem, because the Swiss company does not need to be sucking up a large amount of water from the aquifer. You may remember the North Florida Regional Water Supply Plan, y'all approved in conjunction with St. John's Water Management District a few years ago, which clearly shows that pumping anywhere South Florida, North Florida affects the whole region. So I look forward to you doing, acting on behalf of the public interest, and the public does not want these permits. Thank you.
Sorry.